of water supply system. Water is a vital nature resources which forms the basis of all life. It is one of the marvelous gift to us. On the source of earth, 71% is covered by seas and oceans, and remaining 29% is occupied by land. You can see in figure, 96.5% of the water on the earth is salt water. However, only 2.5% is fresh water. Groundwater is 31% of fresh water, and slightly over 2/3 of this is frozen in glaciers and polar ice cap. You can see in figure. Surface water, like other water, is 0.03%. Fresh water is renewable resources. Now, sources of water. There are two types of water sources available on earth: surface water and groundwater. Surface water includes lake, pond, stream, river, and storage reservoir. In groundwater, open well, tube well, artesian well, springs, and infiltration gallery. While designing the water supply system for a town or city, it is necessary to determine total quantity of water required for various purposes. Quantity required for city is depends on rate of demand and population. Now, types of demands are domestic water demand and industrial water demand, institutional and commercial water demand, demand for public uses, fire demand, compensate losses demand, etc. Now, in domestic demand, 50 to 60% of total demand include drinking water, cooking, cleaning, washing, flushing. In industrial demand, 20 to 25% of total demand depends on number of industry and types of industry. In institutional and commercial demand, for shopping center, hostel, school, hospital, and railway. Demands for public use, 5% of total demand includes water required for washing road, water parks, cleaning sewer, fountain. A provision for fire should be made for modern public water supply scheme. Some portion of water is wasted in pipeline due to defective pipe joints, wall and cracks in some pipe. Some water is lost due to unauthorized and illegal connection. So, an allowance of 50% of all these losses and wastages should be made. Main factor that affect water demand are size of city, living standard of the people, climatic condition, quality of water, industrial and commercial activity, pressure in the distribution system, system of sanitation, cost of water, system of supply, metering and method of charging. For efficient distribution system, adequate water pressure required at various points, depending upon the level of source, topography of the area, and other local condition, the water may be forced into distribution system by three ways: gravity system, pumping system, and combined of gravity and pumping system. First, the gravity system. This system, you can see in figure, suitable when source of supply is at sufficient height. This system is most reliable and economical distribution system. The water head available at the consumer is just minimum required. The remaining head is consumed in the friction and other losses. In this pumping system, you can see in figure, treated water is directly pumped into the distribution main without any storage, also called pumping without storage system. High lift pumps are required if power supply fails. Complete stoppage of water supply. This method is not generally used. Next, combined gravity and pumping system. This system is most common system. In this system, treated water is pumped and stored in an elevated distributed reservoir, then supplied to consumer by action of gravity. The excess water during low demand period gets stored in reservoir and gets supplied during high demand period. This system is economical, efficient, and reliable system. The distribution pipes are generally laid below the road pavement and As such, their layout generally follow the layout of road. There are in general four different type of pipe network, any one of which either singly or in combination can be used for particular place. Dead end system, radial system, grid end system and grid ring system. First, you can see in figure dead end system. It is suitable for all town and cities having no definite pattern of road. This system is relatively cheap. In this system, determination of discharges and pressure easier due to less number of work. Main disadvantage is due to many dead ends, stagnation of water occurs in a pipe. In radial system, the area is divided into different zones. The water is pumped into distribution reservoir kept in a middle each zone. The supply pipes are radially ending towards periphery. It gives quick services. In this system, calculation of pipe size is easy. Next, in grid iron system, it is suitable for cities with rectangular layout where the water mains and branches are laid in rectangles. Water is kept in good circulation due to the absence of dead ends. In the cases of breakdown in some section, water is available from some other direction. In this system, exact calculation of sizes of pipe is not possible due to provision of valve on all branches. Next, in ring system, you can see in figure the supply main is laid all along the peripheral road and some mains branch out from the main. This system also follows the grid iron system with the flow pattern similar in character to that of dead end system. So, determination of size of pipe is easy. Water can be supplied to any point from at least two directions. That's all for now. Thank you.